The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 30th, 1972, in Bombay, India.
Sarva Khetre Subharata Chetra Chetra Gaya Jnanam Jatta Jnanam Matavanam Chetra Chetra Gaya Jnanam. His body and the Chetra Gaya, the owner and the occupier of the body. This subject matter we are discussing last night. It is very easy. I was explaining that like this apartment, we are occupying, therefore we are occupier, but we are not the owner. The owner is different person. Similarly, this body, there are two souls, the super soul and the individual, jivatma, parma, brahma, parabrahma. Jivatma is brahma, constitutional, because mamaivamsa jivabhuti, the living entity. They are part and parcel of Krishna, God. Therefore, qualitatively, what is Krishna with the jiva, living entity of the same thing. There is no difference in quality. But quantity there is. Brahmana aham pratistha. The Brahma effulgence, that is standing on Krishna. Krishna is the source of Brahma effulgence. Just like the sun glow is the source of sunshine. Sunshine is very big, all pervading. And sun appears to be located in some place. But which is important? The sunshine is important, or the sun globe is important? Because the sunshine is emanating from the sun. It has no independent existence. As soon as the sun disappears, there is no sunshine. So wherever there is sun, there is sunshine. Therefore, sunshine is dependent on the sun. And within the sun, there are cities, palaces, inhabitants, just like within this planet. There are cities, there are roads, there are so many varieties of living condition. Similarly, in every planet, there is varieties of living condition. Kotisho asesho vasudhadi vibhuti vinnam. From Vedic literature we understand. Jasya praha prabhavato jagadanna koti. Jasya praha. Govinda praha. Krishna praha. Illumination. Praha means illumination. It's like this bulb and the illumination. The illumination is broadcast all over the room. The bulb is located in a place. Similarly, Govinda is located in his planet, which is known as Golokovinda. And from there, his bodily rays are being distributed. Sadvam Kaluidam Brahma. That is Brahma, impersonal Brahma. This impersonal Brahma is the bodily effulgence, rays of Krishna. Yasya prabha prabhavato jagadanda koti kotisu asesa vasudhadi vibhuti hinnam tad brahma nishkalam ananta asesa bhutam govinda vaditutam tamam namam. We do not know actually what is Krishna's potency. Param bhavam ajananti. Avajananti mana mudha. Manasin tanumastitam. Param bhavam ajananti. People, mudhas, without knowing Krishna's potency, how he is working, how his potencies are working. Parasya brahmana shakti akhilam jagat. Sadvedam akhilam jagat. In the Vishnu Purana, it is said, parasya brahmana shakti ekasthanishtita sharne josna vistarina jatha. Parasya brahmana shakti tathaiva akhilam jagat. Ekasthane sthita sthane, agni, fire, just like sometimes we see fire on the beach, but illuminated. Similarly, God, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is situated in his planet, Goloka Vrindavan. Goloka eva nivasati akhilatma bhuta. Although he is situated in his own place, he can be present everywhere. That is God. We are sitting in this room, we are not sitting in another room. But Krishna, he can sit in his Goloka Vrindavan, he can dance in the gopis, but he is everywhere. With his full potential. There is defense. That Krishna explained to Arjuna that I, first of all, explain this Bhagavad Gita to the sun god. Arjuna, to clear the matter, inquired from him, aparang bhavato janma paro janma vivasvata. So, Arjuna knew that Krishna can remember 40 millions of years ago he spoke to the sun god. But to clear the misconception of others who will later on read Bhagavad Gita, he inquired the question that, my dear Krishna, we are born very recently. How is it that you say that you explain this Bhagavad Gita 40 million years ago? In that answer, Krishna said that, yes, you were also present at that time when I explained. Because Krishna and Arjuna, they are constant company, friends, parsha, eternal associate. When Krishna comes, he comes with his associates. That's right. If you invite king, that does not mean the king alone. The king comes along with secretaries, commanders, ministers, soldiers, so many. Similarly, whenever Krishna comes, yadadadahi dharma sagrani bhavati bharata tadatmanam sijamaham. At that time Krishna, all his associates also come. So Krishna says that the defense is that you have forgotten. That is the difference between Krishna, God, and ordinary living entity. Krishna says, Vedaham Samatitam. He knows past, present, future. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Vedanta Sutra, It is said, janmādhasyata annayāt kitarasascha artisu abhigyā. He knows everything, nook and corner, whatever is going on in the nook and corner of this creation. He cannot hide anything from Krishna. Sarvastha chāham vidhikan nimishya. I am situated in everyone's heart. Matta smriti jnanam apohana vishya. I may forget, but because Krishna knows that I wanted to enjoy something in this material world, he gives me the chance. Now I give you the opportunity. Enjoy. You wanted a body like this, all right, he takes this body. You wanted a body like demigod in heavenly planet, like Indra or Brahma, all right, take this body. And if you wanted a body like hawk, peace, stool, all right, take this body. Jidhadhamam Prabhadvante. Whatever you want, Krishna is witness. Ishara sarvabhutanam iddesha arjuna tisthati. So he is noting down your desires. And he is giving you opportunity. Just like if somebody is kind upon me, just like our Kartika is very kind, he has given me this room. If I say, Kartika, this room does not suit me, give me that room. Yes, Chaitanya? Yes, Karma. This is a question of love and affection. So Krishna is so affectionate to the living entity. Whatever he wants, he is giving. Come on, take it. Therefore, we find so many varieties of body. Why so many varieties of body? Because the living entity wants a particular type of apartment. If this type of apartment would have been given to me, I would have been very much happy. All right, it's happy. But the owner of the apartment is Krishna. Therefore here it is said, khetraṁ vanchapi māmaniddhi sarva khetri subha. So the living entity is the occupier of this body. And the owner is Krishna. Therefore Krishna's another name is Rishikesha. Rishikesha. This body means the senses. We are enjoying with this body means we are enjoying the sense gratification. My eye used to see something very beautiful. So God has given us this eye, see nicely, to your heart's content. I want to touch something soft. Krishna has given us, all right, you take opportunity. Eko bahunam vidhati kaman. This is the Vedic idioms. That one Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, he giving us satisfaction. Whatever you want to enjoy, he's given us full facility within this material world. But because we do not know what is actual enjoyment, therefore this so-called enjoyment is turning to be distress condition. Just like a child, if he is given full freedom, all right, my dear child, whatever you like to do. So he cannot stay in one kind of engagement, sometimes this, sometimes that, sometimes this, sometimes that. He is not happy. But if he follows the instruction of the parent, my dear child, you do like this, you eat like that, then he is happy. If he takes the freedom in his own hand, it is not possible to become happy. Similarly, Krishna has given us a certain type of body. I am the occupier of this body and I am enjoying. But because my calculation is mistaken, Krishna bhulia jeev bhogavan chakare, pasete mayatare japotiya dhare. As soon as we forget Krishna, as soon as we forget that this body is given by Krishna, this body should be utilized for the satisfaction of Krishna. That is real self, that is real Lord. If I am given this apartment by somebody to live, I cannot dissatisfy, then I will ask, please vacate. That will be a distressed condition for me. So why people are suffering? The people are suffering because he has been, one has been given all the facilities as he deserves. But because that is his own program, it is not satisfied. If you accept Krishna's program, then he is good. That is Krishna consciousness movement. We are asking people to follow Krishna's program. Don't plan your own rascal program. You'll never be able. But we are busy for rascal program. We do not know what is happening as a resultant action. That means, yajñāsya karma annatra karma bandhan. If you work simply for satisfaction of Krishna, that is called yajña. Krishna's another name is yajña. Or Vishnu, yajñesha. So, yajñāsya karma, that's nice. You are free from any interaction or resultant action of your karma. You are not responsible. It is very, very easy to understand. Just like in an office, if you work for the satisfaction of the proprietor, then you have no responsibility. Either loss or gain, you are free. But if you create your own plan and work for under your own responsibility, then you will suffer or enjoy. Actually, there is no enjoyment. It is simply suffering. So, that is going on. Yajñātha karma annatra karma bandhana. We are becoming bound. We have got this body according to the karma of my past life, and again I am creating another series of karma. I have to accept another body and finish that karma. Again I am creating another karma. This is going on. Nūnaṁ pramatta kuruti vikarma yadindriya prītaye aprinoti nathādhumanne jato ātmano yam athannapi klesate āsadeha. This is the instruction given by Rishabhde to his son. Nūnaṁ pramatta. All these living entities, they have become mad. We can see very easily, whole world, wherever the big cities, they are working just like mad. So many cars, so many flyways, so many under subways, and always busy. But kurute bikarma, they are not working very nicely. Because karma, vikarma, akarma. These things have to be understood. Karma does not mean that anything you like, it becomes karma. Just like monkey. Monkey, whatever he does, it is simply mischievous. Therefore sometimes we ask, you are an ass, you are monkey. There is activity, but there is no meaning. There is no meaning. Jumping. Monkey, whatever you see, So this kind of activities are not karma. Foolishly, rascal, dumbly, that is not karma. Karma means prescribed duties. Prescribed duties. Janma karma. Guna karma. Chatupannam maya system guna karma vibhavasa. Guna karma. Chatupannam. According to Vedic civilization, there are four divisions of karma. Because there are three qualities of the material nature. Satagun, Rajagun, Tamagun. So, when we come to certain type of activity or accept certain type of body, Krishna is giving us opportunity. I want a certain type of body, Krishna is doing. Krishna is giving through the agency of material nature. Karanam gunasangasya sadasat janma jivanishu. Why the living entity having different types of body, sat asat, some types of body are nice. Suppose you become demigod, Indra, Chandra, that's very nice. But if you become dog or worm in the stool, that is not very nice. But we have to. Why? Karanam, the reason is guna sangasya. As we associate with the gunas, there are three gunas, qualities of the material nature. Satagun, Rajagun, Tamagun. So if we associate with Satagun, Tuddham Vatshanti Sattasva, then those are associated with Satagun. This is very easy to understand. If you become a nice, educated person, good character, he will be always welcome anywhere, good position. And if you are a thief, that's tell, without any education, then your position will be different. So, karanam guna sammas. So, if we associate with goodness of the material nature, then we are promoted to the higher planetary system where we get better comforts of life, long duration of life, so many facilities. Similarly, Uddham Vatshanti Sattvastha Madhya Tishthanti Rajasa. Those who are associating with the qualities of passion, they remain within this middle planetary system, Bhu Bhuvasa. And then Javanna Guna Vittishta Adho Vatshanti Tamasa. And if we associate with tamasic qualities, then degraded to lower species of life, lower planetary system, dark planetary system. There are many planets that are dark, as we have got a part of this planet also. 6 months dark, 6 months light. There are so many different varieties of planets. This is it. We are wandering from different planetary system, different this way. Karanam gunasangas. And the society, the human society, not the animal society. Krishna says, Chatubannam maya system gunakarma. Gunakarma vibhava. So, according to guna, if we are associated with satagun, then that class is called Brahman. If one is associated with rajagun, that class is called Kshatriya. If one is associating with mixed guna, especially Rajaguna and Tamaguna, that class is called Vaishya. And if one is associating with Tamaguna, that class is called Shudra. Chatupanna Maya system, Guna Karma Bhuhav. So, in this way there are varieties of life. But that opportunity is given by Krishna because he is witness. He is Hanumanta Upadrashta. He is seeing everything. He is reading our heart. Ishara Sarvabhutanam Riddhesho Arjuna Tishtati. So in this way, we are changing different varieties of life. Sometimes, human beings, sometimes animals, sometimes demigods, sometimes something else, sometimes rich man, sometimes poor man, sometimes brahmana, sometimes sudra. In this way we are wandering in different species of life and different positions in different planets. There are millions and trillions of planets, and there are 8,400,000 species of life. In this way we are wandering. This is our position. This is not very good business. Bhutta bhutta praviyate. We accept that we have got this now. Human form, no body, Mr. such and such, very good position, very good business, very good. But at any moment I will be kicked out. At any moment. That is no guarantee. And again, I will have to accept, according to my karma, another body, where I may not get this position. I may not be even human being, because according to my mentality, I'll get the body. Jangjangamapi smaran loke tadattanti kalevaram. Our next birth will be settled according to the mental condition at the time of death. So that mental condition one has to practice. What kind of practice? That is also how the practice should be done. That is also indicated in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti deva prata devan, pitrin janti pitrin prata. They are trying to go to the moon planet, but you cannot go in that way. That is not possible. You cannot go by force in any planet. You have to prepare yourself. Just in this planet also, if you want to go to some other country in America, you have to prepare yourself for passport, visa, and so many papers, P-form, bank balance, visa, so many. You cannot by force that I have come to America. The immigration department will immediately check where is your passport, where is your visa, where is your bona fide. Similarly, if such rules and regulations are here, even in this planet, how you dare to go into the moon planet or other planet by force? This is all childish. Now they have stopped. The American government has stopped financing this foolish excursion going to the moon planet. They have stopped. They have now come to stand. Simply, these so-called scientists, they are experimenting on public money and wasting. Long, long ago, when I wrote my book, Easy Journey to Other Planets, I discussed this moon planet excursion simply childish and foolish. And about 2-3 years ago, in San Francisco, the press reporter asked my opinion about the moon planet. So I told them, it is simply waste of time and money. And now it is happening. Long ago I said this. This is not possible. Although there are innumerous planets, but even if you go to the moon planet, your problem is not solved. What is the benefit if you go to moon planet? How your problem is solved? The real problem is that I am forced to accept different types of body. Janma mrityu jarabhyadhi. And as soon as I accept body, I have to be under the tribulation of material nature. That was advised by Rishabdev. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. All these foolish rascals, being mad, they are acting against the laws of nature. Vikarma means against the laws of nature. That is vikarma. Karma means prescribed duties. And akarma means doing something which will have no effect. Three things are there.
Karma, vikarma, akarma. Karma means prescribed duty. If you want, because you want to do business, you must do according to the rules and regulations, license of the government, then you make profit, be happy. That's another thing. And if you act vikarma against the rules and regulations of the state, you commit theft or this or that, then you'll suffer. Vikarma. And akarma means you act in such a way that you become liberated. Akarma. You are not bound up. That akarma is yajna. Yajna artha karma. Anyatra karma bandhana. If you act for Vishnu or Krishna, then you are not, liable of the responsibilities of karma, because you are doing everything for Krishna. Just like Arjuna did. Arjuna was thinking that if I kill my grandfather, the other side, then I shall be merged into the sinful activities. He is my superior, he is my guru, and he is my... In this way he was thinking. Actually, it was so. So he was declining to fight, because that was karma. But when he decided to fight on the order of Krishna, that is not karma. That if there is any sin, that is, it may be transferred to Krishna. Just like if you kill some animal with your stick, the stick is not responsible, you are responsible. Similarly, if I become a stick, an instrument in the hands of Krishna, then I am not responsible for any karma. Otherwise, I am responsible. Just like a soldier, his business is killing by the order of the state. He is killing so many persons and he is getting recognition, medal, gold medal. And as soon as he comes home, if he kills one person, he will be hanged. He can say, "My dear sir, I killed so many persons in the battlefield, I was awarded gold medal, now I have killed only one person, why you are hanging me?" And because you have done for your own sense gratification. And so many soldiers, men you killed in the battlefield, that was the order of the state. This is the same position. Yajnartha means to act on the order of the Supreme. That is called yajna. Anything which you act for satisfaction of the Supreme, that is called yajna. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.